Why do you understand? sabem, your city is preparing facilities to continue to be ahead of the numbers. And so far, on this year side, we are ahead of the numbers. And we're going to continue doing that as long as we continue to behave. If the people of the country behave properly, they take care of them or herself, naturally, our hospital will not be choked. Our frontliners will have enough energy to address patients. So, I need you to participate. But please continue to feel the more of our people. Salamat na kami po. Huwag yung marami din ang sila na doon. Hopefully, it's a big yard in a good situation. Can you say that? Eight. At least, we have something for you. Something for you to see. And, you know, to harm possibly your community or your family. So, we
TV. TV. Principal.
Dami naman yung
ano. Nurse station. Oh, yes. Nurse station. So dito sila nagpipilis. Wow.
Isin niya sa mga
ano niya boss ah. Kita mo may air.
Paganda na paganda.
Girl na girl ah.
Ito kasi yung woman ano,
ang babae.
Oh, lamig ah.
Oh, ito mo ah.
Ahead, sir.
Pagkatapos.
Pwede na rito. Baka mo. Channel 4.
Pwede na rito mag-interview. Walang access sa
Samaritan yung isa sa PCI. Ngayon din pang atin.
ito ang dinyan sa kanila.
Utilize namin yung pera na pinadala ni President. Yung namin kinuha. 290. Wala pinambili namin ng laki na supplement. No other things. Plus ito.
Dito, malapit na. Malapit na. Dito ka, dito.
Teka, Mayor, paulit-ulit. So, donate na po yan. Naka-record ha,
yung delpan or less about 60. So,
60 to 70, and we're gonna build more. And we have 171 bed capacity for COVID-19 patients. Yung ating 480 as of now, because of today, is about 14%. Awa naman ng Diyos, meron pa rin kami. Marami rin kami. As we speak, we have about at least 30,000. We have conducted about 42,000 already, rapid testing. And we have conducted more than 7,000 swab testing. So we're going to continue to raise the numbers with regard to testing and mass testing. And hopefully we can quarantine them as soon as possible. I want to with the help and cooperation.
Are you really talking about the capacity of Manila to do mass testing? Does this relate na kaya nang ready na ang Manila for GCQ? Does it mean something?
No, we're just trying to do our job in our own little way. One, it is logical to trace. Two, after tracing, to test immediate interaction with a COVID patient, positive COVID patient, and to mass test the entire community, as many as possible, with the result, with regard to the result of tracing. And isolate them if they are going to turn out positive under IgG or IgM. Then test them in the quarantine facilities like this. While waiting, they are in a safe manner, attended by our professionals in Manila Health Department, headed by Dr. Boxpam. Then, if they turn out to be real positive, itatransmit naman natin sila sa health institution na ating mga hospital para mabigyan ng proper care. We're going to discuss that tonight. So, ano na ang real status ng Manila, Metro Manila, ng bansa. Then after that, I think we're going to have our decision. Because I want to decide on the basis of facts. Ayoko lang yung para bakit na inuhulaan ko lang kung wala rin sa pangkain. But I want to decide on things that are factually and data are available and real data are there to be analyzed, and we will decide on the same thing that when we do lockdown or ECP or ECP. That's what I'm going to Well, it's going to be challenging. I'm for it because I don't want to fight and be afraid of COVID while it is dangerous. I think the people of Manila is smart enough not to get sick. Naintindihan ko, naniniwala ko sa mga taga-Manila na hinug na sa kanilang kaisipan ang bigat at pagkadelikado at pagkakahawa sa COVID-19. And I think they will protect themselves, take care of themselves, and hopefully they're going to do that because that's one way or simple way of cooperating with the effort of the government, national, local, and fighting COVID.
Pero yung terms of readiness,
kaya na sa ating medical, so far with the numbers, no, as we progress, so far yung ating kapasidad, kaya pa. But, you know, virus is a very fluid situation. Numbers may arise suddenly, and we are aware of that, and we're trying to bring the COVID in terms of numbers. Hopefully, they allow us. Always follow the guidelines of IATF because you want to synchronize the action plan of IATF.
like what we're doing with you guys.
Mayor, sa amin naman po, kung sa kasakan po magkaroon ng GCO, open
po ba ang Maynila para po? Well, it's going to be challenging, but we have to. We need to move. We need to go on with our lives. And I think the people of Manila is smart enough to take care of themselves. Because nakita na rin ng mga taga-Manila yung pagkadelikado ng COVID-19. I think pag-iingatan nila ang kanilang sarili. But at the same time, you know, what is sustainable is for the people to go on with their normal lives. Pero kailangan dahan-dahan. So that we can adapt to the new norms of social behavior. So self-discipline and care for one another is a must, as a matter of participation ng taong bayan. So that we can continue as government to focus on how to confront efficiently COVID-19, like what your city is doing today.
Mayor, kung sakasakali nga po, tumungo na tayo sa GCQ, ano po yung mga paghahanda na ginagawa?
Okay, ito po. We're going to build more quarantine facilities, thinking and banking that there will be numbers rise, and hopefully not. We're creating our own laboratory. We're strengthening our medical equipment or facilities and making more space for COVID-19 patients in terms of room and bedroom or ward for isolation in our medical institution, and the temporary quarantine of any individual na baka nakawa. And we will continue the mass testing. As you all know, modesty aside, kung hindi na sa support ang loko, I think numbers don't lie. I think we're about to go 8,000 already with test swabbing, and more than 40,000 rapid testing in the city, and it will continue to grow because we still have supplies on our own and coming from donations with regard to rapid testing. So we will continue to mass test our people. We will try to be the world standard in terms of percentage per population in a particular geography. We will follow those type of guidelines as a universal rule in addressing COVID-19. At the same time, we'll follow the guidelines of our authorities, in this case, IATF and the UH, so that we will act in synchrony. And the same thing that we are asking our people, hopefully, may awan Diyos, people will follow.
Mayor, last na po, reaction na po doon sa mga nahuli po sa RECO, yung gumagawa po ng mga IDs.
Eh talagang ano eh, dapat yung makulong lahat. I have no heart loss with them. Taking advantage of the weakness of others, especially in trying times, especially in crisis, especially in pandemic, they should be jailed. I don't mind. They should. Thank you. Sinagot ko na kanina.
Isang ikot lang, request.
Isang.
Sige. Isang ikot.
Thank you.